all that. Some of them are soft. Some of them are crisp. You see how, as simple as this is, you see the degrees of effect, the character of the turning of the fabric he's able to get, right? Then, probably with a color that is lighter than that, he began to, you know, give himself some indications of where things are going to be on his face, just where things are going to be. Then he starts this process of heightening with the light. Now he's not using, he knows that when he gets down here, the shirt is going to be white, okay? And you see where it's thick, there's a warmth to it. And you see that warmth is, you know it's warm because you compare it to the gray. See the gray? That's the scumble. Now scumble doesn't mean like a rough handling. It has nothing to do with the degree of handling. Scumble is something lighter over something darker where the dark comes through causing that gray. It could be invisible. You know, it could be something you don't even see. In many paintings, like Claude Lorraine, or any painting, Caravaggio too, there are scumbles over surfaces that disappear. You don't see them. But they're causing things to turn gray in places where they want that to happen.
Because of the differentiated light from a scumble?
Scumble's not rough. It's not about that. It's just, it could be invisible. It could be like so smooth and pounced. In fact, that's what it was. It was pounce it with a soft brush like it's into an absolutely smooth cell. Okay? There are two polarities of indirect painting, glazing and scumbling. So what are the definitions? A glaze is a darker color in a diaphanous state or semi-transparent sort of state over a lighter ground. Darker over lighter, the light comes through, gives a very warm. Look at Katze 2 over there.
No, the timer.
I thought it was video games. Anyway, okay. So darker over light with the light coming through. Okay? Mm-hmm. Transparent. Glaze. That's a glaze. A scumble is lighter over darker. It's the exact opposite. Where the darkness is coming through, causing this gray. You see that? Okay, those are the polarities. When Titian famously said, I paint with 30 or 40 glazes. You may have heard this expression. It's confusing, because in Italian, the word for glaze and scumble is the same. It's velatura. In English, there are two words. There's glaze and scumble. Okay, so when he says 30 or 40 glazes, he means glaze it, scumble. Glaze it, scumble. Glaze it, scumble. Those two operations, when taken together, you'll see that a glaze has a rather warming effect, and a scumble always has a cooling effect.
Does it matter what color it is?
No. As long as it's lighter over darker. Like, for example, I could go, if my shadows go too black, I can take raw sienna. Just straight raw sienna, which is hot and warm, you know? And rub it over the shadows as a scumble. The scumble makes it slightly cooler, so it doesn't look like yellow in the shadows. Mm-hmm. And I'm rubbing it, remember, on it. And yet it warms it. It warms and gives light inside of the shadows. You see? So these things, glazing and scumble, operate throughout painting, throughout the entire course of the painting. Okay? Now.
Sorry, Linda, I didn't hear that.
Are you talking to me? Okay, so he takes this, he knows that his whites are going to be here. So he's not going to use white over here. But he's using something significantly light. Now, you don't know what he may have glazed over this. We don't know. He may not have matched this exact color immediately. We don't know. I think what he did was he approximated a warmer color for the face with some local color, lips, okay? The coolness is in areas, you know, locally, I mean, here. But you see, some of this he could have initiated with the scumble. Some of that gray in there, okay? It's certainly put on in a much finer manner. All of this area at one point was transparent. And he started on the lights and was working the lights, you know? And then he started to pull scumble over here. Now, the scumble he put over here wasn't white, obviously. It would have been too blue. But if you put a kind of warmish color that's lighter than this, lighter than that, you know, it causes it to be neutral, right? Neither cool nor warm, but it looks coolish compared to the warmth of the light. See that? Very subtle, but very easily obtained. You know, I mean, the drawing itself is not easy. And the grace, the thing that makes Ang Ang is not easy. That's rocket science. That's not. But the simple operation a chimpanzee could do. And if you look at the thousands of paintings by mediocre artists throughout history, they know these operations. It's not going to make the painting great. But knowing the operation is knowing something very important. And knowing the operation, its history in relationship to form, and its development in subsequent painting is really important. So you see the continuous skin? It's one continuous skin. It's not like chopped up with pieces. Okay? Now, he may have even, you know, have done that slightly lighter and then glazed it in position afterwards. So some of the warmth that's over top of this and over top of the face even, maybe rubbed out, you could have glazed that all down again. You see definitely the face is more developed than other parts of the picture, right? Look how direct the hand is painted. The hand is painted very directly. He knows that he can, now look at, it's not like perfect hand, but look at the thing, he does this, you know? He finds the lightest light of the hand there. Mm-hmm. Even though he didn't articulate all of this stuff as perfectly as possible, it makes the hand go back in space by bringing the light out here. So the light and the way you're using light is just defining the form in space. It's proximity to your eye, it's distance from your eye. Okay, that's happening all the time. That color there, it could be this color, but my guess is that after he did this, he mixed the color sort of like that, like an English red, and stuck it in there. Okay? Stuff like that.